Here we go.
The Warriors and Kings just played the most mesmerizing and mind-bending opening playoff game I've ever seen, and the supercharged tactics and skill in this contest might just represent the future of basketball. Right out of the gate, the Kings zip De'Aaron Fox up from the baseline off of two screens, and that's to set up a Spain pick and roll, where Domantas Sabonis sets a screen for Fox, Kevin Huerter sets a screen for Sabonis, but instead he slips out to the perimeter early, which creates massive confusion for the Warriors with one defender trailing Sabonis. Kevon Looney jumps in front to take away the roll pass. That means Steph Curry has to go to Huerter. He moves it along to Barnes for an open three in the corner that just rims out. So the Warriors answer back by setting a screen out near half court so Curry can whip it to Draymond Green, get it right back on a handoff, and that's a pretty good look for Steph that just rims out. So on the offensive rebound, the slower Harrison Barnes ends up on Curry. They reset by putting him and Sabonis in pick and roll. Barnes can't get around the screen. Sabonis has to switch onto Steph, and he needs help on a drive, which draws a second defender. Curry makes the basic pass to the corner, and Dante DiVincenzo cans of three. Whew! Last year, we chronicled how hard this Warriors offense was to guard, screening, moving, and cutting into open space. And that was certainly on full display. Klay Thompson cuts backdoor here. The Kings actually react really well, but Klay just moves it along and relocates to the corner, and perpetual movement shooting is deadly. But the Kings' beautiful offense was on full display too. They set up an empty side handoff for Huerter, and he gets downhill and puts two defenders on a trampoline for a drop-off dunk. The two-man game with Sabonis is really hard to defend without help, so when Andrew Wiggins creeps over, Huerter shoots it to the opposite side for an open three, and even though it rims out, Klay had to close hard, which frees up the offensive rebound. And after Green's block, Sabonis uses his size to clean up. The Warriors must feel like they're looking in a mirror at times with Sacramento's constant movement and cutting actions. This all creates confusion, even for the champs. The Warriors switch the staggered screens, so the same players set screens for Huerter off the ball. DiVincenzo expects Kevin to curl over the top, but he takes a shallow route instead. So when Dante calls for a switch, Draymond naturally follows Huerter. Only Poole and DiVincenzo thought they were switching, and it's another red velvet connection. Or take a simple pick and roll in the middle of the court. Harrison Barnes is cutting through to distract his man. Jordan Poole is glued to a shooter waiting for him to cut. So when Monk attacks Gary Payton, it's an isolation game, and he finishes one-on-one. Monk's quickness off the bounce was a factor all night long. Both Curry and Kevon Looney seem surprised as he blows by Andrew Wiggins, and on this one, he's again able to attack Wiggins off the bounce, cut back into open space, and spin one off the glass. Monk's speed also helps the Kings push the pace, hitting the gas in transition and just blowing by Payton, which forces help. And on the kickout, they swing it around to Fox, who has enough time to write a novel because the Warriors haven't recovered. De'Aaron is the unofficial king of pace right now, straining teams off of made baskets by upshifting past players because he's faster than, like, everyone. This one's off a make. He's in the front court in 2 seconds, collapses the entire defense, stays under control to leap out and fake a handoff only to spit it over to Monk, who massages the net for three more. Fox's speed is devastating during the Kings' half-court sets too. Keegan Murray's movement occupies Curry, and Fox can use either screen. And most importantly, there's a screen for Huerter to flare off of, which means there's no one to stop Fox when Payton gets picked off, Draymond slides over, and it's a foul and free throws. This time, they just clear out the entire side. The Warriors don't pre-rotate an extra defender, DiVincenzo gives him a cushion and stays in front well, but that's still a comfortable little shot. Later in the quarter, in the same spot, they do overload the side, which means the opposite corner is open and it's a pitch and catch three because so many Kings can shoot. Fox's own shooting improvement has been critical to the offense this year, adding consistency on his mid-range peel back and especially inching closer to league average on his open three-pointers so he can punish sagging defenders. Another key part of De'Aaron's game is his body control and specifically deceleration, stopping himself as fast as he starts. Naturally, the Warriors went under all of his screens and dropped the big man way off, opening up his floater, and he had a bunch of success getting downhill into Looney. Kevon actually played a big role on the other end defending Sabonis. Domas is integral to the Kings' handoff actions, but the Warriors just sagged Looney way off him and dared him to shoot, and he's not much of a marksman from long range. When Sabonis attacked the space off the dribble, he had little success the entire night, running into the wall of Kevon, and Looney used his strength and timing to deny easy scores near the rim, yielding a ton of strong contests, and by my count, blocking Sabonis at least twice right near the basket. With the Warriors up 108-107, Looney sagged way off Domas, they set up a screen for Fox, and Wiggins goes under the pick, per the scouting report, and they were giving Fox this three, and he was making it. On the other end, the Warriors run essentially the identical play. Sabonis is sagged off Looney, and they screen for a Clay handoff, and even with Monk flying in to help, Thompson puts Golden State back up one. That was deja vu, since a minute earlier he put the Warriors in front after Fox went under a screen, so it was De'Aaron's turn to answer, splitting Looney in the pick and roll and attempting to baptize Clay, but he lost it on the way up, only for Monk to pick it up and hurl himself back into the thick of it, and that's a tough call on Looney. Now it was the Warriors' turn to answer, and with the clock low and Sabonis coming way out to take away the three, Thompson drove baseline, only to find Curry, who arches a moon ball falling out of bounds, and the Dubs are back up two. I'm not sure that was even Curry's most impressive play, taking a full lap around the court to start the half, giving new meaning to the term relocate by giving it up and getting it back not once, but twice, only to finish with a one-handed scoop in traffic. Anyway, after putting Golden State in front, he couldn't stay in front of Monk, who drew three defenders, hit the corner, and again, Fox was open on the trail, and does anyone miss in this game? Unfortunately for the Warriors, Clay blinked first, and off his miss and in transition, Monk's pace was again an issue, rejecting the screen with a crossover to Dust Thompson, and this time Looney jumped into him for more free throws. Trailing by three, Curry wants to pass it and chase it, but Fox does a remarkable job running with him and providing just a little rearview pressure around the screen. And then, again, that relentless King's speed pushes it down the court. Monk hits Fox, who touches it to Sabonis for a dunk, and it's a 5-point lead. And perhaps the biggest challenge for Looney is just keeping up with these thoroughbreds in transition. A minute later, it's still a 6-point game. Curry starts dancing and upfakes Sabonis into a beautiful finish, but then Sacramento answers with their own version, getting Fox into a ton of space, stepping back versus Clay, only to give him the hezzy and Looney fouls on the contest. The skills exhibition wasn't over as Barnes switches onto Curry, only for Steph to rock him into a step back, and that's good defense and just ridiculous offense. With the Kings clinging to a 2-point lead, I love that their offensive principles still kicked in. Fox plays two-man with Sabonis, wheels downhill when he's cut off, which forces a Draymond switch, And Herter sees just 6 seconds on the clock, so he sprints up to screen, which drags Curry behind him, and that momentum runs him into Fox when he shows himself for a critical late foul. After some mad scrambles, the Warriors had a great look to win, but Wiggins left it short. And with 3 seconds to go, Monk actually jumped too early at a potential Curry shot, only for Steph to rush a one-legged three, and the Kings held on to survive in an absolute classic. We've seen the Warriors ramp up their movement principles over the years in the playoffs, adding in counter after counter, and the Kings leaned into their offensive principles more as the game wore on. Neither team devolved into isolation or basic pick and roll, but instead it was dribble handoffs, movement, and that unending Sacramento pace. This was an electrifying performance worthy of a championship stage, and hopefully this was the beginning of more incredibly skilled, high-level basketball in this series, and just maybe for the future of the league itself. To support this channel directly, check out patreon.com/thinkingbasketball. Also, check out the Thinking Basketball podcast, where we'll be talking about this series and the entire first round as part of our ongoing in-depth coverage of the NBA playoffs. Let me know what you think so far and of the incredible offense we saw in this game. And wherever you're listening from, say it with me. I hope you are having a great day.